Welcome back to the Ghost Key. I am Grain. Today we are finally gonna move on and get out of Fuchsia City. There you go. Forgot the name of it was. But anyhow, I do have some absolutely wonderful news regarding my capture card. Route 19. Am I going the wrong way? Still make some time flat on there. Uh oh. So it's close for construction. Go south from Pallet Town. We have to go south from Pallet Town? Is that really how we're supposed to do this? Let's see how we're supposed to go about it. You know, we might actually have to do that, yeah. I need my flying Pokemon. I need that fucking bird, whatever the hell its name was. Fucking Kenya. There we go. But anyhow, regarding my capture card. You know, like I said before, they were, like, really, really backlogged on orders and all that stuff and all that good shit, which is fine. I wasn't too upset about that. But it was sent out, and I honestly expected it to take, like, something like 2 weeks, you know, maybe even 3 weeks in the mail. It's only going to take a handful of days. It should be here Monday, which this episode will probably be up Sunday. So, yeah. It should be around then. Do we have to go? Shit, how do we have to do this again? Trying to remember. Mount Moon is what this is. I'm trying to remember without having to use the book how we got there. I want to say, because you are Viridian Forest, you're Diglett's Cave, this is Pewter. I want to say we got to do Diglett's Cave again, don't we? Is that right? You gotta fly to Vermilion and do Diglett's Cave again, I think. I'm pretty sure, I think. Methinks. We're gonna find out here in a minute. You know, this episode may be just us figuring out how to get back over there. Remember, this gave us a lot of trouble in the last one. But anyhow, Wrong way. But like I said, we should be back on track to record Omega Ruby as soon as it comes out, as soon as I get it. I will certainly. Do I have to fucking this large Pokemon see if it looks so content? Mother of God. Okay. So we get to go back. You know, I think I remember. Don't we have to do the radio thing or some shit? Isn't that right? We go back over to Lavender and do some shit there, I think. Don't we? Because there's a radio tower or something there. Is that right? Because then they convert the... Yeah, didn't they convert the fucking Pokemon Tower, the dead Pokemon Tower or whatever, into a radio tower? Pretty sure, yeah. Yeah. Now, who do I gotta fucking talk to get this shit happening? It's Kanto's radio tower. Alright, what are you? You're some fucking garden house of memories, my Pokemon search. Blah, 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 blah. What are you? You are... Lavender Velma. Okay, alright. Don't really care. Alright. That's that. So we're gonna roll up in here. I think we're supposed to get something from them. Is that right? Put on good shows, blah 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 blah. Welcome, feel free to look around anywhere on this floor, blah 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 blah. Power plant's problems, so and blah 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 blah. Direct loaded in, yep. My Pokegear has been upgraded. Why is my Pokemon needing to turn into more radio programs here in Kanto? Wah ha 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 ha. Alright, what's your super music director? I'm responsible for the gorgeous some of the grabbing music off the air. Alright. Sorry, but you can only enter the door. Blah, 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 blah. Taken over. Aha! Since they were taken over by a criminal bunch of people. In sheet. Alright, anyway, we need to go. Alright, do we have what it takes now to go down there? I'm not entirely sure. This is just a bunch of. Do you remember? Because, yeah, this does sound familiar. I think you are supposed to go this way. And then we gotta wake up the dude. Dude, do I have that? Do I have the fucking radio thing or whatever? I need to switch into, what's his name? I need to switch into Mofo, don't I? I'm trying to remember this shit, like I said, without looking at the book. Because I gotta kind of go over there and dig through some shit to grab it and then bring it out. So I'm not really sure if I really want to do that right now. I'm going to try. I'm going to try and be smart and problem solve here. Because this is going to be a lot of what we're doing in Omega Ruby and shit. And it's going to be fun. It's going to be fun. Got to get my thinking cap on and shit, man. Gotta get my thinking cap on and remember this shit. Because I don't know. I got nothing as far as my jokes went. But anyhow, like I said, we are all ready to go. It should be here. My capture card should be here next week. So I'll spend almost all of next week. I'm going to try and record all my episodes for this upcoming week. Today and tomorrow. And then that way all I have to do is just stick around with that all week next week and get that ready to go. Because that's what, obviously, you know, we need that. I'm not going to wait till, like, the day that it comes out to, like, try and figure out how to use the fucking thing. I mean, that's stupid. But anyhow, should be okay. I think I've already done a little bit of looking around on stuff and whatnot. Like, on the website that I bought it from, you know, all the help shit to figure out how to fucking hook it up once I get it and all that good stuff. So it should be all right. Should be okay. Keyword should be. I'm really hoping so. Because, you know, I'm just ready for something to go right for once. You know what I mean? Like, I mean, since I got this new capture card for my PC, it's worked out wonderfully. And, you know, after I figured out how to fucking get it to work without dropping the audio and shit all the time. But now that I've got that going, you know, we should be fine in general. And like I said, I'm pretty excited about it. I think everything should work out well. But not as well as this fucking poison is working on my fucking mofo. Getting a little pissed about that. I don't like that shit. None. Me no likey that shit. But, yeah, test my Pokemon. Rest my Pokemon. Actually, this may end up being our episode here. It's just clearing out these guys. Which, in all honesty, may not be a bad thing. Because the training and stuff we're gonna need. And all that good shit. I mean, we're gonna need quite a bit. And all that good stuff. I think I should mention this too. I don't think we're gonna be able to finish this by the time Omega Ruby and all that stuff comes out. I'm not going to give up on it. I will eventually finish it. But I can tell you right now, that's why I'm gonna try and stock up on recording stuff today. And tomorrow I'm gonna try and record a shit ton so I can get as much of it out of the way as possible. Hopefully try and get to the point where all we need to do is grind a bunch to either take on the Elite Four again or Red. Oh shit, Azatu. You are flying and psychic, right? Let's see if this will fucking do you good. Oh no, that doesn't look good. It's not going fast enough. Ooh, we got luckies. It's super effectives. But I did try my girlfriend's, I should mention this as well, my girlfriend's schedule has changed yet again. So, what that means is this, it means that Thursday and Friday I probably won't be uploading anything. I will be trying to at least upload a Football Manager episode Thursday or Friday. Now, I tried getting that done, I did have it all ready to go, and I just never got around to uploading it on Friday because the new WoW expansion came out and she wanted to play that and shit, so I was like, alright, well, we'll dick around with that. And by the way, that expansion, my god. If Blizzard has learned anything, it hasn't been how to fucking put their shit together and make it fucking work. I mean, for the love of god, this game has been out for 10 fucking years. And you want, alright, I'll tell you, I know this is really off topic, but last night when we were playing, since the fucking garrison thing broke and we were stuck in the sky, we decided to go play on, we play on a Brazilian server. Well, we're going to start playing on a Brazilian server now more often. But anyway, on the Brazilian server, we were in Stranglethorn Vale, if you know where that is. And I hopped on my mount, and then I went around, and then I dispelled it, got off of it, whatever. But it didn't get me off of it. Graphically, I was still sitting on the fucking thing, and I was just doing all my moves. But my camera was zoomed in as if I was not on it anymore. And I was like looking up my mammoth's ass. It was fantastic. And I'm sitting here thinking, how the fuck does this sort of thing happen when I'm not even anywhere near the new shit? That's the shit that gets me about World of Warcraft. They've always had problems with that. They'll upload new shit that will somehow have some giant catastrophic effect on things that are a million miles away in entirely different zones, doing entirely different things. It's ridiculous. It's absolutely dumb. But anyway, that just goes to show how inept they are, in my honest opinion, at their own shit. I mean, I'm maybe I'm a douche, and I'm a bit hard on them, but I mean, I guess like I said, for the money you pay, I expect better. You know, I mean, I think we're all kind of entitled to that, especially when you, like I said, you pay a lot of money. In fact, a friend of ours, you know, he paid for the expansion. This is funny too. You're gonna like this. He paid for the expansion, and the fucking game would not recognize that he paid for the expansion. They took out the money and everything, but the game wouldn't let him play the new content. Needless to say, he's pretty pissed, and rightly so. I mean, I don't fucking blame him. I'd be fucking raging out. I mean, you pay whatever it is, $60 or whatever the cost of it is, 50, 60, whatever the hell it was. I pre-ordered mine a while ago with the girlfriend to get the special shit and stuff to make her happy. But anyway, you know, to pay that sort of money, any money really, and not get the fucking product, and he put in a ticket, and of course, you know, he's got to wait. It said the estimated wait time is 2 days and 5 hours. Now, think about that for a second. That's like buying Pokemon, and like, well, you know, we aren't sure that you really bought it, so, you know, we're just gonna sit on this, and we'll help you out in 2.5 days. Meanwhile, all your fucking friends are playing Omega Ruby and shit, you know, for the last 3 days, and you haven't been able to play it because, well, we'll get around to you. You know, I'd be pretty fucking pissed too. I mean, like I said, I don't blame him, but like once again, I mean, you know, you expect better. I mean, I haven't seen any other MMOs have this big of a fucking issue, you know, just coming out, launching. Of course, yeah, you can say the whole thing about, oh, yeah, it's got a shit ton of subscribers. Yeah, but you know what? They know how many subs they have. They know how many people are going to be on that game. I mean, come on. It is their game. They know how many subs they have. They know how many subscribers they have. They know how many active subs they have. They know how many inactive subs they have. You should at least plan for your servers and everything, which, by the way, the servers, just the world server and everything, just kept fucking crashing last night. It was pretty funny. You know, but once again, if you know all this shit, you should plan for it. I mean, I'm sorry, like, that doesn't make any sense. Well, you know, we've got 1 million subs, but we're only gonna, you know, put servers together that'll support 200,000, and, you know, the game should be fine with 200,000, but any more than that, you know, it'll blow up. That just doesn't make sense, man. I'm sorry. That's just stupid. Ill-advised and ill-planned. I mean, that's just crazy. But anyway, the Garrison thing is kind of cool. And, you know, once they get their shit figured out here in the next month and figure out how to work their own goddamn game, maybe it'll be fun and worthwhile and not fucking break every 10 minutes. But we'll see. You know, that's one thing I like about Pokemon. Although they did have that big giant, that big ass, whatever the hell it was, the thing, the don't save in Lumio City thing. Yeah, you remember that? Yeah, you save in the streets and your ass gets stuck. Yeah, they did have that, which was funny. I thought that was hilarious, which made me think. I was like, how did that skip testing? I mean, how did they miss that in testing? Did no one think to save in the streets in Lumio City? You know, I mean, I'm just saying. I mean, you know. But, you know, at least they figured their shit out pretty quick. You know, unlike, wow, Blizzard, you know. I mean, at least, like I said, I give Nintendo and Game Freak or whoever was responsible for fixing that shit all the props in the world, because they figured that shit out pretty fast and got it figured out. And, of course, it was like a little patch. And, of course, you know, that's something, too. I know a lot of people are asking about that. And I know Game Freak and everyone says they're not going to do DLC content because they're not going to turn this into some little fucking pay $5 here, you know, nickel and dime. They're just going to sell you the game and have the game be the game and then move on, you know, continue doing what they're doing, which is pretty much a proven product as far as I'm concerned. But that's just me. I mean, they've got a proven formula, and I mean, there are some tweaks, as we've mentioned before, that they could throw out there. It makes things a little different, a little bit better, but honestly, I like the formula that's in Pokemon. I mean, I think a lot of people do, obviously. I mean, no one would play it if, you know, if it wasn't very good. I mean, I'm just saying. I mean, it's not like, well, I'll rephrase that. To say, it's not like people play bad games. Yeah, a lot of people play a lot of bad games. A lot of bad games. I mean, have you seen all them farm simulators? Oh my god. Who plays those? Who plays that shit? Alright, now, if I'm right, don't we go into the Pokegear, do the radio thing, And don't we have to marry a doke? Pokemon music? Where is this? Wow, why does this come in so bad? Can we get this Snap trainer profiles? The fuck is this shit? Wait, I'm gonna try something. You're gonna see my mouse here in a second. There we go. Oh, no. No. Don't no put my Pokemon to sleep with a soothing lullaby. Don't do that. No, that's not what we want to happen. Wake it up. Wake this motherfucker up. Oh, shit. I don't know what to do. I thought we were supposed to turn it to the radio thing. We don't have any... See, I don't think they give us... It's not the Pokeflute, because that's a different game, right? Yeah, the Tidal Bell, Peripod's Basement Key, blah, 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 blah. Eldorado Coin Keys, Bicycle. Alright, anyway, this is probably a good place to stop this episode anyhow. So that's what we're going to do. If you made it this far on YouTube, you know what to do. I want to look at it. I want to save it like this. Alright, if you made it this far on YouTube, you know what to do. Thanks a lot for watching, and remember, the Ghost Key is the only place where pants are optional.